Have you ever heard of the General Governorate? It was a place for the undesirables. On the 1st of September 1939, Germany invaded Poland. After their conquest, the eastern part of Poland went to the Soviets. Two western parts were annexed by the German Reich, and the central part was named the General Governorate. It was basically the dumping ground for the undesirables. It was the place where the Jews and the Poles had to live and die. Hey, welcome back, regular viewers, and if you're new, welcome to History Hustle. I'm Stefan, I'm a history teacher, and I'm hustling history on location for you. And the only thing you have to do is consider subscribing, also hit the notification bell to become part of the hustle. Let's start. Now, before the First World War, Poland for a very long time did not exist as a sovereign nation. And after the First World War, the Second Polish Republic was created. It gained ground at Germany's expense, so from the get-go there were severe anti-Polish sentiments in Germany. Now the Nazis, they capitalized on this because they saw the Poles and also the Slavs as an inferior race, a race that had to be conquered and a race that had to be dominated. On the 1st of September 1939, the Nazis invaded Poland from the west, and the Soviets did so from the east, and they carved up Poland. The eastern part went to the Soviet Union, and two western parts were annexed by the German Reich. They were named Danzig-West Prussia and Wartheland. Now, these were not the exact territories that Poland had annexed from Germany in 1918, but more like an extension of these. And what was left was a central area that was named the General Government. The capital of this area was not the former Polish capital, Warsaw. No, it became Krakow. And in the castle you see behind me, that is where the German General Governor Hans Frank ruled Poland from. His wife, Brigitte Herbst, called herself the Queen of Poland. And basically, all Poles and Jews were expelled from the Western territories and had to be lived here. So you can say that the General Government was a dumping ground for the undesirables. Now, the Nazi view towards the General Government was not that of an occupied nation. According to the Nazis, Poland had ceased to exist after their invasion of September 1939. The Polish people now were a conquered people that had to live by the rules of the conqueror. And some of these rules, according to historian Martin Gilbert, were the following. All Poles must leave the pavement free for Germans. In shops and at marketplace, representatives of the German authorities and local ethnic Germans must be served first. Male Polish nationals must raise their hats to the important personalities of the state, party and armed forces. Whoever annoys or speaks to German women and girls will receive exemplary punishment. Polish females who speak to or annoy German nationalists will be sent to brothels. And with exemplary punishment was meant the death penalty. Random executions were common every day. Already right after the German invasion of Poland, SS Einsatzgruppe rounded up countless Polish intellectuals and they were executed by the thousands during the so-called Intelligentsia action and Operation Tannenberg. A tragic example of this was the Palmiry massacre. The Nazis wanted to wipe out the Polish intelligentsia. And random theft, murder and rape were common among SS and Wehrmacht troops. Now Frank had pointed out in a wartime interview where he referred to a German leaflet in Nazi-occupied Czech stating seven Czech students had been executed, that Poland wouldn't have enough threes to produce the amount of paper to cover all the executions of Poles that took place under his command. Now note here that these executions were often carried out in public. It was not uncommon that the bodies of the hanged were left dangling for days or even weeks. For every German that was killed by the Polish resistance, 50 to 100 Poles were killed in retaliation. Hans Frank obliged the Jews to work from the age of 12 and the Poles to work for the Germans from the age of 18. Now the whole concept of forced labor is very broad and it basically involves all the countries that were occupied by the Nazis. So I'll probably dedicate a future episode to that, so keep an eye on this channel by subscribing. Hans Frank also oversaw the segregation of the Jews, and this happened by ghettos. Basically the Jews were put into secluded ghettos. The biggest ghetto was located in the former Polish capital of Warsaw, but also other Polish cities like Krakow, Łódź and Lublin had their ghettos. These ghettos were overcrowded and many people died of disease and starvation. Eventually, all these ghettos would become liquidated and its inhabitants sent to concentration camps. Looking at resistance, well, basically Polish resistance immediately sprung up after the Nazi invasion 1939, and the biggest resistance movement was the Armia Krajowa, in short the AK, also known as the Home Army, who committed many acts of sabotage and resistance against the Nazi rule. Their biggest fight was the Warsaw Uprising. I'll get to that in a second. Now, collaboration, there wasn't that much collaboration of Poles with the Nazis. Why? Well, basically because the Nazis clearly presented themselves as an oppressor. They said, you're the conquered people and we're the conquerors. So therefore, not many Poles worked for the Nazis, although some volunteered for labor in Germany. And then there was also the Blue Police, where basically Poles had the function of police officers to maintain order, but there's still debate whether these people can be viewed as active collaborators. Now, when the general government was extended by District Galician, where many ethnic Ukrainians lived, we saw much more collaboration there. And that was basically due to the fact that the Ukrainians were first oppressed by the Poles, then by Stalin, and now the Nazis. So they basically worked with the Nazis because of the thought, the enemy of the enemy is my friend. The general government consisted of four districts. I'm talking about Krakow, Warsaw, Lublin, and Radom. Now, after the Nazi invasion of the Soviet Union, the general government was extended by District Galician, which were basically the former territories of the Second Polish Republic that were annexed by Stalin and later overrun by the Nazis. When the Soviets poured into Poland in 1944, the Armia Krajowa made one big stand in Warsaw. This was also known as the Warsaw Uprising. They were counting on Soviet support. However, the Soviets had halted their advance at the Vistula. So therefore, the Armia Krajowa was on its own. The Nazis put down the uprising with brutal force, destroyed the city, and pulled out. I made a whole video about the Warsaw Uprising, the links are in the description. With the Vistula Oder Offensive, the Nazis were expelled from Poland, and with that, the general government ceased to exist. The former general governor, Hans Frank, was later tried at the Nuremberg tribunals in 1946. He openly stated remorse, but he said he didn't know anything of the Nazi death camps in his general government. He was found guilty for war crimes and crimes against humanity, and for that he was executed. His son, Nicholas Frank, became a journalist and wrote a book where he condemned his father's actions. Now, with the end of Nazi rule in Poland, it did unfortunately not meant the end of oppression. If you want to know more about the terror of the Soviet Union in Poland, click right here to check out the video I shot in Warsaw. Check me out on Instagram at History Hustle for exclusive picture. Do not forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching. See you later.